Waging War on Corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
We're back live, ladies and gentlemen, taking your phone calls. And we're going to get Jordan Maxwell on to break down some of the programming in the media. Be a very interesting interview. Also, there's breaking news up on Infowars.com. It's really powerful video that I want to try to get to with Jordan. Albuquerque residents vow to storm another city council meeting. Protesters demand arrest of police chief over spate of shootings. So we're going to be getting to that. It's just huge. And it shows how when the people move, it's over. And if the cops ever shoot a crowd of peaceful people like this, the revolution's going to start. And then you're going to find out who the good police are from the bad police, and we'll end up taking back large areas of this country, but then the globalists will cut the power off and blockade the major railways and hubs. That's why they've been trying to make us dependent and not self-sufficient so they can siege the U.S. and bring us down under the New World Order. That's the admitted Pentagon plan, by the way. I'm not saying the troops are involved. They're the most awake because they understand military operations. They can see it being set up against their own families. Ed, Wally, you're on the air from Tejas. Go ahead. All right. Well, I'm doing good. How about you? All right. He's gone. Let's go to Kathy in Florida. Kathy, you're on the air.
Hi. I had a question. I was wondering if you thought that the Vatican, specifically the Jesuits, could be the head of the snake.
Well, I mean, there's a New World Order program. Just like we said, the globalists run the Russians, they run the U.S., they run Israel, they run Japan. They didn't run Japan, so they went and got them weapons and tricked them into a war and then overthrew them and have controlled them ever since. Not saying the Japanese government was good either. It just wasn't under globalist control. But undoubtedly, the Jesuits have been involved in all sorts of political intrigue, promoting the European Union, believing because Europe's Catholic that they'll get their seat in the New World Order. But the Jesuits or any other group is a diverse group, like the Masons. But you have the Illuminati infiltrating Masonry. So it's very sophisticated. What you have, and this is actually in Cass Sunstein's plans in Divide and Conquer, just what we were talking about with the Normans earlier, is that you have schools of thought that say it's the Jews, or it's the Masons, or it's the White Devils, or it's the Black Devils, or it's the Vatican, or it's the Jesuits, or it's the Protestants, or it's the... No, it's predatory people that use systems of manipulation to control and dumb down humanity. And so that is the threat, is evil people. Like I'm not Catholic, but the Catholic Church got infiltrated, like every other form of education and system, by pedophile rings. Look at Congress. Look at Homeland Security. It's not that truancy workers are all pedophiles. They just have one of the highest instances of it. It's not saying everybody at Penn State's a pedophile. It's a pedophile ring took it over. So absolutely, the Jesuits at certain levels have been involved promoting socialism and things in the last century, and I don't like it. But you could argue they're doing that to control the socialist movement to stop it. You could argue the Jesuits worked with Hitler, but also a group worked against him. So I really historically try to not scapegoat one group or the other, but show where it actually came from or what happened. I know this, you're not supposed to have anyone from the Society of Jesus as Pope, so why do you have a Jesuit Pope right now? That violates Catholic law right there. You see, this is what I'm talking about. Very sophisticated things are going on right now, ma'am. What do you think of what I just said?
Well, I know you're supposed to follow the money, right? And the Vatican is the one with the most money. So.
And who says that?
I thought it was just known that they have, the most money.
I will just say this. The people that say the Catholics run it all, mainly Seventh-day Adventists, who are great people, but it's a Seventh-day Adventist group, lie about me and say that I work for the Vatican and stuff. It's pure bull. My family are famous Protestants that literally started Texas. were, I mean, right there starting shipping Protestant Bibles in. So those people are liars.
General, what do you think about the FBI saying that there's a terror alert on Monday about a potential Fort Hood situation?
The police are shoving people, shoving Alex, shoving the crowd.
Here we go, folks. I'm being assaulted.
Whether it's the radio show, the news websites, documentary films, or the nightly news, InfoWars is the tip of the spear.
Is this another false flag stage attack to take our civil liberties and put more homeland security while sticking the hands down on the pants on the streets?
It's up to us to set brush fires in the minds of men and women everywhere. And that's what PrisonPlanet.tv is designed to do.
You watch the Assad regime is going to be blamed or accused of using chemical weapons against the so-called rebels.
What we see now is a war against reality. It's a war against the truth.
It's more vital than ever that supporters of freedom become members of PrisonPlanet.tv and share their membership with up to 11 friends and family. Visit InfoWarsNews.com today. Become a member, share your membership, and help take the InfoWar to the next level.
Globalist social engineers are not just targeting us with propaganda. They are manipulating our genetics. We are being targeted at every level by estrogen mimickers that lower our testosterone and other hormones and natural compounds that the body needs. After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic super male vitality formula sourced from powerful organic herbs and then concentrated for maximum potency. Super Male Vitality was developed to activate your body's own natural processes instead of using synthetic chemicals. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose. For a limited time, we are offering 15% off Super Male Vitality at InfoWarsLife.com to introduce you to this powerful supplement. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality. InfoWarsLife.com.
A chemical spill contaminating the water supply in 9 West Virginia counties.
This year alone, over 300,000 people in West Virginia had their drinking water contaminated.
What are the health effects of having these drugs in our drinking water?
It's forced medical treatment without the consent of residents.
My friends, water filtration is one of the most basic actions you can take to protect you and your family from the harmful toxins and heavy metals in your tap water.
On average, the county says it sprays with the glyphosate at least once a week.
Few filters cut out the glyphosate that is found in water supply. Supplies worldwide. Remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, hydrofluorosilicic acid, sodium hexafluorosilicate.
Fluoride, it is in tea, it's in coffee, it's in water, it's in bread, it's in toothpaste.
It is our responsibility to protect our families. The establishment's not going to do it. It's time to take action. It's time to filter our water. Visit InfoWarsStore.com and use promo code WATER to get 10% off their entire family of incredible products. Or call toll free 888-253-3139.
Crashing through the lies and disinformation, it's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
What is the Illuminati? Who are the practitioners of this ancient faith? It certainly didn't begin in 1775, 1776. Where is our world going? How is the Illuminati plan progressing? We are joined for the rest of the hour by best-selling author, researcher, occult researcher, Jordan Maxwell. And Jordan Maxwell really is a great political and geopolitical, but also esoteric mind. And I want him today to use a few examples that he brought up to me that people can easily understand of programming in Hollywood and in television. And then I want to ask him, why do we suddenly see open satanic rituals at the Super Bowl with Madonna and with all the other big singers and people? What are they trying to usher in at the Olympics and the rest of it? Why do they believe ritual is so powerful? Why do they believe if they tell you in a Tom Clancy book 2 years before what they actually do, how that lesser magic, as they call it, gives them power? And you can argue it's really giving them power. Or is it programming our subconscious? Is it science or is it a cult? Do they really believe in spirits at Skull and Bones, or are they using it as an archetype in the Carl Jung way? Let's just get past all the religious dogma and what men and priests try to say God is, the universe is. Let's talk about what the elite themselves believe. I've been to Bohemian Grove infiltrating it. I'm telling you, they were in religious rapture. They believe they're worshiping Lucifer. But are there people above them that are being scientific about it? What is the internet about and this new singularity? And the fact that I believe feeding all of our data into it, the internet is already a AI conscious system because humans are interfacing with it at such a level that it is already conscious and is able to predict the future, which they admit. They admit it's able to predict the future. I call that a being. Will Lucifer, if it's a real entity from his perspective, become godlike with the artificial, technological, omnipresent system they're building on this planet to be duplicated into space? Are they building the godship? Now, again, this is their view. I know what their deepest secrets are. I know Jordan Maxwell has talked to a lot of the highest level initiates of the Illuminati, and I know he can't talk about a lot of that. He gets threatened. But I want to get his take on it all today. So, Jordan Maxwell, thank you for joining us. We'll talk more about this later in the hour. But first, I know there's folks that have websites that aren't yours. Your official websites have been taken over before. You, up front, give people the real official place people go to find your work. Because I know a lot's been done to shut your funding off. And it's been rough for you and your family. So I know you don't want to bring this up, but I do. Up front, how do people support you?
Well, thank you, Alex, for being on the show and always being there as a good friend. The only place I have on the web now that's legitimately mine is called Jordan Maxwell Show, S-H-O-W, very simple, Jordan Maxwell Show. It's a small podcast that some of my friends helped put together, and so I have at least an email for that. And so that's the only thing I have at the moment. I was going good for a while until I got sabotaged. But if you want to contact me, I'm not allowing any comments to be made because I got too many negative comments.
Sure, Jordan, the trolls love to come after you. I think it's best you just put out your info. You've been fighting for 60 years. I think you deserve to just put out your info.
That's what I feel. I'm tired of struggling to justify myself. And so I'm tired of my name being ridiculed, my work being ridiculed and sabotaged. So I've just put it out there and I figure whoever's supposed to hear me will and whoever's not supposed to hear me won't. So I just do the best I can under the circumstances.
And folks can find a donate button there to keep the radio show going. I know you've had health issues and some family has, so it's been rough for you. Wow, so much going on. Icon of the awakening movement, Jordan Maxwell. You heard my whole preface of what the elite are trying to build. Who are the Illuminati? What really makes them tick? At their core, what are we facing?
Well, I think you were exactly right when you were talking to the young lady before the break. The mere fact that the entire world seems to be in the grip of a demonic, otherworldly power, which is sucking mankind down into oblivion with demonic depravity, secret societies, black robes, all of the occultism of the world is now in your face. And so I totally agree with you that there is a spiritual dynamics or a matrix at work. But that being the case, then that would explain why all systems are demonic now. All of our institutions and governmental agencies, educational systems, are all under some kind of a other world, what I would call demonic and depravity. And it implies that there's something very, very big going on with not just America, but with the whole entire human family on the earth. And that is frightening because most people have no idea of the severity and the perimeters of how big this this thing really is. It's in banking, it's in religion, government. It is a cancer that's eating up the body politics of the earth, period. So it is, I believe, a war between the good and evil, between the darkness and light, between God and the devil. Although I you know, I've been talking about religion and theology, which is my favorite subject anyway. But I'm interested also in symbolism and pattern recognition. And my